can listen to what I'm telling you today, hear what I'm sharing with you today, your life is going to be easy. Life is going to be easy. Blessing, that's where we are. The blessing. What is the blessing? What is the blessing? We need to understand something that other people that read the Bible understood. They very much understood it, the blessing. You know, in our generation, when you tell a person, God bless you, he will simply say, thank you. It doesn't mean anything to him. It's just another religious cliche. And because of that, it will not work. Because whatever will work in your life, it is activated by faith. It will be activated by faith. That's how the things of God function. They don't work just because they are spoken to you. They work because you believe them. That's why in Hebrews chapter 4, verse 2, the Bible says, they had the same gospel, the children of Israel, they had the gospel, but it did not profit them because it was not mixed with faith. In other words, it was spoken, but they never believed it. Or if they believed it or they took it light, I don't know. But the things of God should not be taken light if they're going to work in your life. So I want to talk to you about this subject. To bless, it means to empower, to prosper. To bless someone, you're saying, I'm empowering you to prosper. You are empowering you to prosper. A blessing is an empowerment of prosperity. When you're saying, that man is blessed, you are saying, that man has been empowered to prosper. That man has been empowered to prosper. You know, even the people of the world have understood that life is beyond what we see. I was watching another minister yesterday, a prophet, very prophetic. He was confessing how he went to be initiated in cult for him. Very popular, very famous. How he went to cult and was initiated for him to be what he was. So now I was confessing what he went through, how he traveled all over the world, all over around Africa to be initiated. And the rituals that he had to perform every time he went to church. I'm not talking about someone, I'm not talking about apostoli, those people are not apostoli, but I'm talking about those people who are ritualists, you can tell. Today's it. I'm not talking about those people. I'm talking about a person like me standing in front of you. But before we go to church, the first thing he does in order to entice the people, they are praying, they are fasting, the church is doing everything. Every day he had to cut up a pigeon or a chicken and put it upon a horn and blow every time, then speak and speak and speak. When he goes to church, he prays for people. They will be falling, things will be happening, things will be happening, but he's using a different power. I'm telling you one thing, people should understand, this world has become so terrible. Don't just desire what you see. Begin to confess how they were faking miracles in the church. Shared about a lot of things, but I'm not there. But I'm telling you, they understand that success is beyond what is happening. It's beyond the physical. They understand there's a power behind a person to be very successful or constantly successful. They understand that. Even though he went and looked for a different power or a different, an evil power or a cultic power in order for him to perform the miracles and make the money and so on and so on. Even shared about when he went to that place, there were little children there. Little children that are being stolen all around to be sacrificed by people who are looking for money. They are doing different things. People are looking for things just for money. Just for them to be prosperous. You are looking at them from afar. You are saying, I wish I can be like that person. They don't even know what is happening behind the scenes. Some, they don't sleep. He himself said, I was not sleeping for years. I never sleep during the night. I sleep during the day because I couldn't. So, They understand that there's power behind success. And that's what I'm talking about. A blessing means to empower to prosper. A blessing is an empowerment of prosperity. To prosper, when we say someone is prosperous, it means everything goes well with him. All things are going well with you. When you are prosperous, it means your everything about you goes well. Because we talk about blessing, it means everything about that particular individual, it goes well with him. It goes well with him. That's a blessed man. And a lot of people say, things are not going to go well with you every time. It's because you're not blessed. When you're blessed, all things are going well with you. Glory to Jesus. Everything that is connected to you prospers when you're blessed. It means you will always live in increase. When you're blessed, you will live in increase. And you cannot be defeated. When someone is blessed, he will live a life where he increases. It can be financial increase, spiritual will increase. He will increase in things. He will increase in joy. He will increase in resources. The person who is blessed will always increase. And number two, he will not be defeated. He cannot be defeated. In other words, he is preserved, protected. As I was listening to the same guy, which when he was going to that incantation, the first thing that they did, they put protection on him before they wake him out. So in Christianity also, when a person is blessed, he cannot be defeated. And everything about him increases. When he's involved, things are going to go well for him. It's a tell-all. There's a force behind that is backing his cause. That's a blessing. And it's amazing how we as children of God are not aware of it. You are protected, preserved, because part of the blessing is to be protected. Part of the blessing is to be preserved. Part of the blessing is to be divinely favored. You are preserved, you are protected. You are divinely favored. It's a blessing. I'm defining someone who's blessed. You are preserved. You are protected. You are divinely favored. There's favor around you. You always win where others fail. When a person is blessed, he wins when others are failing. Glory to Jesus. Say, I win. When others are failing. Where others are failing, you win. Where others will never prosper, we prosper. Not every church can prosper here in the land, in this land. Other churches will come one Sunday. It will be the last time the church. It will be their last service. They will not survive here. But when you are blessed, you prosper even if you can go to an island. When you are blessed, you are blessed. Hallelujah. Tell them, when you are blessed, you are blessed. I want you to prove it for yourself. Tell them, I want you to prove it for yourself. After teaching you what I'm teaching you, cell leaders, kids, teachers, you must understand this. How can we bless our children? How can we bless our youth? Again. Now in Genesis chapter 24, I'm not going to open that verse, but I'm just going to quote it. The Bible says Abraham, God had blessed Abraham in all things. It means the man was caused to prosper. The man was empowered to prosper. He has prospered in all things. The man, Abraham, was blessed in all things. Imagine, the man was blessed in everything. The man was blessed in all sides. God had blessed him in all things. That's what the Bible says. And when you go to Genesis 26, verse number 1 to verse 3, remember he had a son, Isaac. And the Bible says God gave, Abraham gave gift to the sons that he had with other concubines in Tomzaka Mocheruak. He gave them gift. But to Isaac, he gave everything. Everything he gave it to Isaac. And remember, he was what? He was very rich, the Bible says. Very wealthy. And he handed everything to Isaac. And gave... Abandona, Mama Cherry, please. Send them off. Then when you go to Genesis 26, the Bible says, God came and spoke. In fact, before Genesis 25, verse number, I think verse 11. After Abraham died, God appeared to Isaac and blessed him. That's what the Bible says. Now in Genesis 26, God appeared to Isaac and said, Isaac, stay in this place. Stay in this place. Don't go to Egypt and I will bless you. I will bless you. Question is this. The man already had everything. The man was already rich. The man had livestock. The man had everything because he inherited from his father. But God still says, I have to bless you. In other words, what he was having was a proceed, was a product of blessing. It was not a blessing. The wealth he had, the gold he had, the silver he had, it was not a blessing. It was the proceed of the blessing. That is why God had to also appear to him in order to bless him. Because having the proceed of blessing isn't a blessing. Having a house doesn't mean you're blessed. Having a car doesn't mean you're blessed. Getting married doesn't mean you're blessed. Having children, it doesn't mean you're blessed. There are many children who are headed to their family. When their parents look at them, they feel like God does not love them. When they look at their children, they see the hatred of God upon their lives. Lord, why? Just imagine. You can't call that a blessing. But God had to come to Isaac again and tell him, Isaac, stay here, I will bless you. In other words, I will empower you to prosper. I will protect you, I will preserve you. I will favor you. That's what God was saying to Isaac. When you read verse 12 of Genesis 26, the Bible says, Isaac sowed in the land and God blessed him. He was already a multi-millionaire, according to our own standard, or a billionaire. God appeared to him and blessed him. After blessing him, invested him, the Bible says the man began to prosper. In other words, there was a continuation of a mighty move of prosperity. When the man began to prosper, because verse 12 says he blessed him, he continued prospering until he became very prosperous and the Philistine envied him. What was the result of the prosperity? The blessing. In other words, God blessed him. Praise Jesus. God blessed him. Then we go to, I think this one we should open. Eh? In Genesis 27. In Genesis 27, he's still a son of Abraham. Son of Isaac, I mean. This is now, Isaac is about to bless his son. Remember, it is now a third generation of the blessed. The grandfather was blessed and was rich. And the son continued in the riches. In other words, the third generation, in other words, they were very wealthy. Because it was a continuation. These people kept on being rich. Even today, check the history. History of life. About the Jewish people. The Jewish history. Go to history. Every great innovation is from them. Seed of Abraham. Every great thing that has happened in this world is from the Jewish people. Why? It's a blessing. Yes. Praise Jesus. Now, this is Isaac. Who was now super blessed, super rich. He's got two sons. He's calling the elder one and saying, my son, I want to bless you. I thought they were blessed because they had everything. They understood something that was beyond what has already materialized or what was beyond what they already have. They understood that what they have was a proceed of something bigger than what they have. They understood what they, the prosperity they had came from somewhere, and that to sustain it. Because SEO please go and get your game, meaning go and hunt and give me something to eat, so I will bless you. Like I am sure, even though in our generation, the sons had Rolls Royce, the sons had mansions, I'm just talking about, it was a third generation of a very successful family, very prosperous family, but still the fathers understood something. What we see is a result of a blessing, is not a blessing. That is why they never cared much about the proceed. They had to stick in what produce the proceed. The Bible says, he called Esau, go and hunt and bring me something, so I will bless you, my son. He was old. He went. And Jacob, he began to, with his mom, because there was a lot of favoritism in that family. Favoritism. The mother loved Jacob. The father loved Esau. Just imagine. I know, even in some families it's like that. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. In some of in many families it's like that. I say, I'm trying to lose boo. I think Shaya called. Glory to Jesus. Praise the Lord. But I would talk about Tangaban, but hesh, Magabunalo. It's a story of favoritism. There was a favoritism in the family. There was just another level of favoritism. Even Isaac was not ready to listen to God. Because I'm sure his wife told him that God, the smaller one will be greater than the young, than the older one. But he did not care. He still wanted Esau blessed. Then the mother began to conspire with his son and said, my son, go and prepare something. I'm going to create, you know, I'm going to make you, because the other one was hairy, which is, Esau was hairy, and Jacob was a smooth guy. So he had to take the goat, skin, and put it on Jacob in honor for the father. When he feels him, he feels as if this is Esau. That's what the Bible says. When Isaac had Jacob, are you my son Esau, Jacob? He said, yes, I'm your son Isaac. With the voice is Jacob. Let me feel you. But the skin is Esau. The voice of Jacob. The skin is Jacob. He's about to catalabano someone's blessing. Just imagine. The skin, I feel it. This is like my son. I can feel it. Even I think when he said that, he began to be quiet. He said, come close. I want to smell you. Because the smell of my son is like a feeling. Yeah, the smell is my son, but the voice. Let me bless you. Then he ate of his game. Then he began to emerge. Praise Jesus. Only surely there, I'm going to read from verse 7 because of time. And he came near and kissed him. And he smelled the smell of his clothing and blessed him and said, surely the smell of my son is like a smell of a field. Surely the smell of my son is the smell of a field, which the Lord had blessed. Therefore, may God give you the dew of heaven in the presence. Which of the fatness of the earth, meaning the best of the earth, and the plenty of grain and wine, let people serve you. I got even be company. Take this company I'm giving to you. Take the cars. They were already rich. Let the fatness of the earth and the plenty of the grain and wine would let people serve you. The man is blessing him. Men serve you, like I'm declaring on your life now. Amen. Youth, may they serve you in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. It's a blessing. You should say, I receive. In other words, even whatever happens around your life, even if they can fight you, they will become your servant. Amen. Because you are empowered to prosper. Amen. Uti, and a pot of grain and wine. Let people serve you, and the nations bow down to you. Be a master over your brethren. Avati, take this position. I'm giving you a command. Now, Uti, be. That's how he blesses him. Uti, be a master. Like I'm telling all of Glorious Gospel, be a master over your peers in the name of Jesus. Yeah. Be a master. Be the Lord wherever you work. I'm blessing you. Yeah. Hallelujah. Uti, be a master over what? Over your brethren, and let your mother's sons bow down to you. Curse be everyone who curses you, and blessed are those who bless you. Jesus. Imagine someone who can try to touch you. He's dead. He's dead. I'm telling the truth. If God wants to kill someone, he has to allow him to touch you. It's the truth. There are people who are untouchable. It's like me. Even if I can leave my house open, you will never enter. Amen. It is the day you die. I'm not going to be the one. He has blessed me. Hallelujah. Amen. And he has blessed you. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. You are protected. You are preserved. You are favored. You are empowered to prosper. Amen. Have you ever seen them? A year will not pass without them being, until something happens to them. Something is just going to happen to them. There are people like that. You ask yourself, what's wrong? But today, that one is coming to an end.
Amen.
Hallelujah to Jesus.
Amen.
Now, after that, he left, and Esau came in, the elder son, after hunting. Now it happened, verse 13, now it happened, as soon as Isaac had finished blessing Jacob, and Jacob had scarcely gone out from the presence of Isaac his father, that Esau's brother came in from hunting. He also had made savory food and brought it to his father, and said to his father, let my father arise and eat his son's game, that your soul may bless me. These people were looking for something bigger than cars and houses and money and all the things that you are looking for. Just imagine, these people are laboring for these things. Yet, Abazana, I understand. And his father Isaac said to him, who are you? So he said, I'm your son, your firstborn Esau. Then Isaac, the father, trembled exceedingly. Why would he tremble? Why would he shake? Because he was worried, who did I give a blessing? Because it might not be Jacob, it might be someone else. You understand? Uti, Isaac trembled exceedingly and said, who? Where is the one who hunted a game and brought it to me and ate all, and I ate all of it before you and came? And before you came, and I have blessed him. And indeed, he shall be blessed. Uti, I'm telling you, the one I bless, I don't know who is it. Uti shall be blessed. Shall be blessed. When Esau heard the words of his father, he cried an exceeding great and bitter cry and said to his father, bless me also. How can a person cry for that? He knows the power of it. He knows the power of it. Bless me, bless me. Oh, my father, but he said, your brother came with deceit and taken away your blessing. Esau said, he is not rightly named Jacob, for he is a supplanted. He supplanted me two times. He took my birthright, and now, look, he had taken away my blessing. He said, have you not preserved a blessing for me, my father? Why? Jacob was a spiritual man. While you are thinking about food, because the man loved food so much, he could trade anything for food. The man was looking for something greater than food. I'll give you the stew, but give me the birthright. Isaac answered and said to Esau, indeed, I have made him your master. How? which I have made him, Bazalwane, this is something big, which I have made him without giving you anything, but I say, I have made you his master. I have made him your master. Konkulu loves doing things that way. I have made him your master. Praise Jesus. So verse 1, Gonje. Oh, and all his brethren I have given to him as servant. With grain and wine I have sustained him. And what I have I've given to him with grain and wine, that is prosperity. Which I have sustained him. Which means everywhere he goes is going to be prosperous. Everything he touches is going to be prosperous. If he's going to go to this business, it's going to be prosperous. If he's going to go to that business, it's going to be prosperous. Whatever comes, whatever he touches, will be prosperous. That's what the Bible says. Glory to Jesus. A blessing. So these people, as much as they had possession, they look beyond the possession and look beyond. They look beyond the possession. Something I want to share with you today and maybe to understand. When you address things, I think you should write the statement down. When you address things and people according to the flesh becomes their permanent experience. When you address things or people according to the flesh, which means when we address physical matters or physical circumstances, we focus on them, they become our permanent, or not even a permanent, they become our only experience. Which means if Isaac was just focused on what he had, his son or his sons may only have had one experience of what he only had. But what he did, he will look away from what he have and begin to do what? To form what he does not have. I want you to see what I'm trying to bring to you. We must train ourselves to look not only at what is seen, or good or bad, because it will stop our blessings. We must be trained. That's what I'm saying. Only you must learn. We must be trained not to look on what we have or what we do not have. We must be trained to look beyond of what we have and what we do not have. Because according to this man, their increase of blessings was determined by what? They acknowledged what they had, but they looked beyond it and saw something bigger than that. That's what caused them to increase in blessings. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 17. For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, is working for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. While we do not look at the things which are seen, but the things which are not seen. Only for the things which are seen are temporal. In other words, Isaac, Jacob, what they had, they saw it as temporary. So they want something that was permanent. So actually, the things that are seen are temporal. It can be a behavior of someone. It's a temporal thing. It can be a witness of someone. When you look and address yourself according to the flesh, or view life according to the flesh, we are only living a temporal life. And we are making a temporal life to be permanent. That's the reason some of you've stayed in the same place for a long time. You don't move forward. You will never increase because you have made a temporal what you see, what you feel, what you can touch to be a temporal. A temporal what you observe to be a permanent thing. That's why I'm quoting these men who look beyond what they had and saw something greater than that. That's what we're saying. We looking not. Uti, there's a glory that has been worked inside of us. While we look not. In other words, I'm looking not on what I'm seeing here. But I look beyond. Uti, because
what is unseen is permanent, but what we see is temporal. In other words, if I can fix my eyes on what I can see and say, this is it, I'm living my life or not on temporal circumstances. But looking beyond this, I'm giving myself an opportunity to manifest what is unseen. Glory to Jesus. That is faith. That is faith. This is a young girl or young lady. He cannot behave well. He's just wayward. As leaders, this is what God was teaching me lately. Sometimes you have to look beyond what is seen.